Chelsea, we are at Amsterdam Whitney Art Gallery. With us is one of the co-owners, Ruthie Tucker. Now, Ruthie, tell us what we can expect today.
Certainly, Crystal. First of all, thank you and welcome to Amsterdam Whitney Gallery's Midsummer Night's Dream Extravaganza. We are so grateful for the beautiful Crystal Heart to film our fabulous artists here in Chelsea. Our Midsummer Night's Dream Extravaganza exhibits artists from all over the world, from the seven continents. We boast there are more stars than there are in the heavens. We feature abstract, figurative, landscape, still life, photography, and we are thrilled and thank you for shining the spotlight on our fabulous artists. Amsterdam Whitney Gallery is located in the heart of Chelsea, and we are thrilled and would love everyone to come down and visit our wonderful artists.
With us, Diane Holland, all the way from what, San Francisco?
San Francisco.
Well, welcome.
Thank you.
And Diane, you've been here before, and tell me a little bit, has anything changed over the last year, or anything new in your technique? Or?
Actually, these are a little bit different in that I have actual abstract food items in them. And the foods that I've represented here are traditional, and they're universal. They've been around for centuries, cheese and wine and melons.
Today at the Amsterdam Whitney Gallery, I have four paintings. They're still lifes, florals, and there's some lemons in there, too. These are lemons from my lemon tree in Palm Springs, California, where I also have a residence and paint. And I took the branch off the tree and set it outside on my patio and painted this little still life outside.
Now, Anna, tell me a little bit about the artwork you have here today.
Okay. This is part of a series that I called Liquid Gardens. You know, to me, you know, the beauty of nature is very important. You know, my art is not about shocking or provoking, you know, but it is about, you know, if there is a message, it's about making people aware how beautiful, you know, nature can be.
I work with glass, and my training has been in architecture, and then before that I did fine art. So I combined the two, and I used glass as the medium to convey my thoughts, my expressions. I have pretty much two series, the nature scapes, and then I have the spiritualism.
With us is Judith Gale, and Judith is originally from
Baltimore, Maryland, but I live in New York City now.
Oh, how are you enjoying New York?
I love it. I love it. Family here, it's great.
Did you move here because of your art?
I went to SVA, so that was one reason, yes, absolutely.
And tell me about the artwork that you have here.
So these paintings are inspired by seashells. They're back row images of seashell patterns that I then play with the color and texture and make them happy and optimistic paintings.
And how did you come up with the subjects, seashells?
Well, my father's an avid seashell collector, so I grew up with shells all around the world.
May I introduce you to the Norwegian artist Asa Burkhout, who is known for her rosy floral paintings, who is inspired by the rosiness and the sheer joy of the floral kingdom. Asa's works celebrate our terrestrial realm, and her noted palette are the beautiful rosy pinks, the magentas, and the pale pinks that really rejoice in the floral kingdom.
Artist, once again, everybody, your name?
Hasna.
Anna Franklin.
Judith Gale.
Diane Holland.
Ann Gores.
Ruthie Tucker. Thank you, Crystal. You're gorgeous.
And once again, good night, everybody. Say good night, everyone, from Amsterdam Whitney Art Gallery. Come down and visit Chelsea, the best. Say goodbye, everyone. Bye. Thanks for watching. Come down and see the art.
Bye.